Hello animation folks and blenderers, I'm pxy-gnomes and welcome to my channel. This video is a tutorial about this cool feature of rigging, which is, I believe they call it like a head tracker system or rig. And actually what's happening here is that I have all the rotations of the head bone, which is here, are controlled by this bone here. So I have, for example, this head tilt on one axis, actually the Z axis, and there is also this rotation, which is the head tracking, and it is something achieved by the combination of the Y axis of the head, so it's a look left and right, and the with the x-axis of rotation, so look top down. And so when you get this whole plane of x-y axis, you have the head tracking. But then you also need the other axis of rotation, the z-axis in this case, to have this tilt, which is fundamental for cool expressions. So one thing that I believe is good practice on rigging is try to have the bones usually perfectly aligned and equivalent in their bone rolls. For example, the head bone here and the head track bone, they are perfectly aligned, and also their gizmo here on the bone rolls are equivalent. It's much simpler to make the transformations on bone controls from target to owner. That should be taken into account when making those rigs full of rotations and constraints is rotation modes, because if you don't plan just a little some of these, you might find yourself in strange situations where, like, for example, I'm trying to tilt the head here, but it's not working, at least not from the 3D view, the main region, but I still can do this from here. But this is pretty annoying, and this is probably a gimbal lock concept I'm having here, an issue. And rotation modes are made so that you can have less of this problem. So in my case here, I've decided that all my four bones here, the two head related bones and the two neck related bones, will have all the same rotation mode, which is I've picked up this XZY Euler, which means basically something like this. The third axis of rotation on that sequence, the y-axis, so for me is the look to the sides, is the one which has the most versatility. It's the major one, so it won't suffer much with gimbal locks. It's higher in priority. Then the first one on the sequence, the X axis, which is top and down, is the second in priority. So not a lot of gimbal locks for the X axis. So okay, and then the middle one, the Z axis, so it's the tilt. I've decided, well, that would be the one that will suffer the most with gimbal locks whenever they will occur. So this is how I've organized this, and it was a good choice apparently. And also certain bone constraints like copy rotation have options regarding rotation mode. So for example, this item order, there is Euler order, so I don't know exactly how this worked, but I left default here and it still worked fine for me in this case. Worth investigating though how this operator would affect the rigs. But I'm not expert in this theory. I know barely nothing. But I know just enough to have it worked for me currently on the types of rigging I'm doing. So that's fair. Check those bone constraints. So what do I have here? There is basically a dump track from the head bone to the head track bone. And the head track bone also have a dump track towards the head bone. So this way they are aligned. They are one tracking the other. This is a good strategy to make these alignments automatic. Another way that this can be done, but for this head tracking system, it's not so interesting, is to use this, where it is, custom shape panel, this override transform. This will put, for example, the I guess in pose space, right here in pose, on pose mode, this will put this bone, the head track, on, oh no, sorry, I need to place this at the head as a reference. Yeah, this will kind of align, but then my bone goes exactly to that same position on pose mode, not on, of course, and this is something that for the head tracking system, it's at least mine, this one here, it's not good, because it's like you're starting to operate your bone from the place here. So this could work very well for a hand IK controller bone, for example, but not for this, because the purpose here is not to grab the head around, is to really to make a reference in world space to head to track. So this is kind of messing up my rotational abilities. So the output is horrible for this case. So it doesn't worth it. But this is very important trick to know: override transform operator. Bone constraint in this rig setup is the copy rotation for the z-axis, which is actually the head tilt here. So let's recreate all this from scratch. Let me delete those bone constraints. So now you see no head tracking anymore, no head tilt anymore, and the head bone is locked anyways, but I can unlock here just to show you that all this can be done from the head bone. And I'm not sure now, but it could be that by having those rotations directly from the limb bone of the head, I could even put quaternion here maybe. I would probably be less likely to gimbal lock, since I have no constraints from rotating directly the head, unless the rotation of the head was somehow influenced by rotation of the neck. Even so, I think this would be safer, but I can't confirm this, but I have this intuition. On the other hand, if I did that, I would have no head tracking system, right? What we need to do is to go to the head bone and add this dump track, but I'll do it differently. I want to first select the target bone of the dump track, the owner bone of the dump track bone constraint, which is the head bone. The shortcut is Ctrl Shift C, but in case you don't know, it's pose menu, then constraints, submenu, and then add with targets. And then let's go to dump track. And this what makes is that already my target bone, the armature and the target bone that I previously selected, is here already. So what we have here is that currently the y-axis, track axis, from the owner bone, the head bone, the owner of the bone constraint, has its local y-axis. See, local y-axis, the length of the bone is always the y-axis. So this is being the track axis. I don't want this, I actually want the Z axis to be. Now it's good. very, very straightforward, very simple, literally straightforward bound constraint, and it's actually making lots of things for me, because what it's currently doing is already getting this plane, xy plane, so two axes at once, to be aligned with this. It's like there was a plane here, but as you see, the gizmo here is not rotating, which, because I just have the damped track from one side and not the other way around. So in principle, it's already making half of the job for me. So let's do another trick here. I'm gonna transfer the bone constraint from this bone to this bone. First, select this bone that I want to have the bone constraints copied. Shift click, select the active bone for the data you want to copy. And then I think there is not a default shortcut for this. One can create that with it's copy constraints to selected bones. With right mouse button click, I could assign a shortcut or add to quick favorites, but I'm not gonna do that now. I just want to copy. So here we go. Now if I go to the head track bone, I have the dump track again. But now what is happening is that it still have the same. It's tracking itself. This shouldn't be allowed, but I don't know. But it's wrong. Usually you cannot select the own bone. But okay, now it disappeared. So let's go to the head now. Here. So now you see that it's already working, this alignment, except that it's invert. Right, so very simple, the z-axis for the negative z-axis, which would be here for that bone. And this is already fixing major issues if I would have tried to do it otherwise. So very good setup here. And the last thing I need to do is to make the head tilt here. So I need a copy rotation. I need the head bone to copy the rotation of the controller bone, the head track bone. And I will use the z-axis on local space from both bones, because they are perfectly aligned in world space. So to do that, let me just select the target bone, then shift click, select the owner bone, Ctrl Shift C, and copy rotation. So now I have already targeted. And if I checked here, probably something would go wrong. No, everything looks good. But I just need the Z axis for this. I don't need anything else, because those other axes already contemplated from the dumped track system. Yes, I will replace, because I don't want to move the head bone, and the head bone is locked anyways. Then local space, yes. Okay, so it's already working. And lastly, one important thing to consider in this rig setup is that if you check the mesh of the neck while I head track this thing, it doesn't really transform or rotates or moves, because the neck bone is not involved directly in these transformations. It could be done, like I could make some sort of head tracking neck tracking right system with the same controller bone I'm using here, but I found out that it might be actually a good feature to have this analyzed in this way, because I still can control the neck. The neck is free to move through this neck controller bone. I can rotate. The rotations are not very smooth, because they are the head bone is parented to the neck bone, this one red, and this neck bone is just copy transforms from this controller neck bone. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you like the content, you can help my channel by subscribing, giving a like, commenting. I'll be glad to answer any questions and participate in conversations. I'm glad to have you around. Happy blendering, and have a great weekend. See ya, folks.